Let us look at what is happening in the entire industry itself. What is driving change? We as consumers, I mean all of us, we are buying more and more equipment, you know, smartphones, smart TVs, mobile phones, tablets, and these are being bought in millions and millions, not small numbers. We also use a lot of rich media, play YouTube videos, access the social network all the time, typically keep the network on, do online reservation systems, online bookings. We are consumers are driving a lot of things. You know? We are using more and more network bandwidth. That's why the telecom providers are providing you, you know, 3G, 4G, and you will see LTE, higher and higher bandwidth network. And of course, there's also cloud computing already in place. And when you access these services, many of the services are hosted in the cloud. And finally, the cloud services require data center to host. So we as consumers are actually driving the change of creating more and more data centers globally. So data centers have servers, storage, networking. Of course, you need power to power all the servers from the grid. There's low power, you need huge generators, UPSs. You need massive cooling equipment to cool all the heat generated by IT equipment, so on. And what's the impact on the environment? Look at, you know, we already talk about recession globally. Right? Last couple of years, the global economy has gone down. We are in this low single digit growth. Look at the global GDP growth. It's a low single digit. But what about the pollution we are causing? Look at the McKinsey report. But from 2007 to 2020, the projected growth is about 11% in the CO2 emissions. We are not talking about tons, we are talking about megatons of CO2 emissions, which has a huge impact on the environment itself. Let's go into a little more detail on the various factors which are driving this change. Let's look at the projected growth of smartphones and the tablets. See, as per the 2011 estimate, we had about 260, 270 million smartphones, expecting a billion smartphones to be there in the world by 2015. And just imagine a billion of these devices, each of them consuming 5 to 10 watt hours of power, roughly. You straight away have billion, you know, watt hours of energy being consumed just by these phones. And you know, similarly, the tablets, right? The projected growth rate of tablets is about, you know, 350 million by 2015. So just as I talked about, you know, these tablets and smartphones itself has a big impact. Although they consume small amount of power by unit, but the sheer numbers in millions and hundreds of millions together, they consume a large amount of power, which itself has a big impact on the, indirectly impact on the environment, because large number of smartphones, devices, themselves consume power directly. Indirectly, they use the network, and the network provider has to add more and more equipment. All the service providers like Facebook, Google, and the Yahoo's of the world have to add a lot more servers, storage, because every day we are adding more and more content. And to keep all this content and power all the servers, you need a huge amount of power. We as a consumer actually are driving this change, and our devices actually are driving this huge increase in CO2 emissions and consumption of power. Let us look at how much of data we have. You know, every year you must have seen, you know, we had, you know, once upon a time we had a megabytes of disk. We have gigabytes, we have terabytes. And the disk size capacity is increasing. On average, look at last decade, year on year, the capacity of a single disk is increasing by about 40% every year. Although disk capacity is increasing 40% a year, the content is increasing at a much faster pace. We always, you know, once upon a time, we said, you know, 20 MB of a disk was very good enough for us. I'm happy with it. But today, I think many of us have a terabyte of disk on the desktops or a laptop. We still find it insufficient. So globally, if you look at the storage capacity worldwide, it's an exabyte. So what's an exabyte? Yeah, you know, 1,000 kilobytes is a megabyte, 1,000 megabytes is a gigabyte, 1,000 gigabyte is a terabyte, 1,000 terabyte is a petabyte, and 1,000 petabyte is an exabyte. And these systems globally, if you were to put together in a system, just look at the amount of space it takes globally. Land, right? Look at the land. Just the acreage space for a data center storage for these devices itself is thousands of acres. We need thousands of acres of data center space just to host this data. where the data are coming from. We are all creating, right? Putting more and more YouTube videos, Facebook pages, Twitter tweets, emails. This is excluding the corporate data, where again we create tons and tons of data for all our business applications. So we are consumers. As consumers, we are having more and more smartphones, tablets. We have probably have, you know, near time we'll be having a few smartphones at home, few tablets at home. Increased number of smartphones has an impact on the telecom infrastructure. So the telecom service provider has to provide more equipment, he has to provide more base stations, more cell towers, and all these things drive his back-end infrastructure itself. You know, more cell towers, more generators. Again, these cell towers need to be put up by a data center which hosts the servers for your billing systems, routing systems, back-end systems, and so on. So there's a huge increase in the telecom infrastructure required. Similarly, all the services we access online, the Facebook, the Google, and Yahoo, they all need to upgrade the infrastructure continuously, which results in increased amount of storage, servers, and network. So what are the challenges for the data center? So as we consumers keep on buying, you know, new equipment, so what is not seen by most of us is a huge challenge faced by data center providers. What are they? See, Intel Gordon Moore long back defined this Moore's law. That means every 2 years we double the 18 months we double the capacity of a CPU in terms of the increasing density or increasing power. How are these servers stored in a data center? Data center basically we have this racks. We call it as a 42U. This is the standard size. A U is a unit of measurement in a rack in a data center. Typically, one U is equal to 1.75 inch. So when you put servers in a rack consumes about, a rack is typically takes, you know, a physical space about 10 square feet. In a 10 square feet of area, we're consuming about 3 to 7 kilowatts of power. I'm saying kilowatts, not kilo kVA, kilowatts of power. But what is happening? The microprocessor manufacturers, the hardware vendors are coming with more and more powerful servers. What is happening with this more and more powerful servers is that in the 42U rack with a 10U itself, I am able to consume 7 kilowatts of power. That means I have a huge rack which is sparsely populated. I am not able to fill the rack because I don't have a sufficient power to power all my servers in a single rack, which means my data center space has to increase hugely because I need to spread the rack. Either option is to spread the rack or increase the density of the servers in the rack. Increasing the density of the servers in the rack has a big impact because electrical cables are laid long back. You can't easily go and change all these back-end cables, your generator, distribution panels. That's one part. Second part is you need to provide more and more cooling. Whatever power server consumes, you need equal amount of power to cool these high-end servers. So cooling is a big challenge today. More number of servers in the rack means you need to provide more air conditioning to cool them. It also increases noise, so weight. So and we look at IT, right? There are two parts of the data center. One is the IT part, is the electrical part. IT part is where we look at provisioning IT, servers, storage, and network equipment. There's also electrical capacity. It means as and when you keep on adding more servers, you need to provision more power. In terms of, you know, you need to add more UPSs, more generators, all your distribution switches. So all the electrical capacity has to be increased, and which is not very easy. And data centers use what is known as power utilization efficiency. I will talk about this little later in the presentation. What does it mean? Data centers use only PV to measure how efficient a data center is, but it's not a good measure. How much does the power cost in a data center? So this is very, very surprising. For those of you who have not been in the data center, have a look at this last blood item. So when you put one rack of servers in a data center, so you need power to power the servers. You also need air conditioning to cool the servers. So one rack of rack space of servers, typically where you can keep around 10 to 15 servers in a data center in one rack, it costs about 1 lakh rupees per month. So imagine a data center of 100 racks, which is not very uncommon these days. You know, 100 racks will have about 1,000 servers. About a crore of rupees electrical bill every month, which is high, and it is not going to come down, it is going to increase over time.